Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Excel video today. We're going to figure out what is the average, but exclude the largest number and the smallest number. And possibly we want to exclude two highest numbers and two lowest numbers. And believe it or not, there's actually an Excel function that will do this called trim mean. But let's go ahead and get into this video right now. So in column A, I've got 20 numbers that range from 100 to 200. That was intentional. If I want to know what is the average, so I'm going to walk you through here, and there will be chapters or bookmarks down below. If you want to just jump to the trim mean function, it's going to be one of the last chapters in here. Feel free to go click on it, but I'm going to do some cool Excel functions that every Excel user should know. So if I don't know what's the average, I'm going to take the average of A2 through A21. If you want to highlight them with the mouse, you can. There's my average. If I don't know what's the highest number, that is the maximum function of A2 to A21. 200 is the maximum or the highest number. Cool tip for you, by the way, A15 has got the 200. The cool tip is this. I just did the max function in cell D3. I need to figure out the lowest now, which is MIN. Instead of having to type it, I'm going to just do control and the key to the left of enter, a single apostrophe. It copies directly whatever was above it. So now I can just change it. And 100 is the lowest cell A4, by the way. So here we go. I want to know what's the average excluding the highest and the lowest. And in case you're wondering, why would I want to do this? Maybe we've got a lot of numbers listed and the average is just looks way off. And the reason it's off is I'm trying to average these numbers. But here's my example. Let's just say that one of these numbers is 80,000. So now my average is just way off. Let me undo that. Or I've got a lot of large numbers and my lowest number is the number 3 or 4. That would throw it off. So that's why you may want to exclude numbers. Two easy ways to do this before I do trim mean. One, I can sum up these numbers and I can subtract the maximum. I can subtract the minimum and divide. Instead of having 20, since I'm subtracting those two, I've got 18. That is clearly wrong. So, let me throw this, need an open and close parenth. There you go. It just happens to be very similar to what it was anyway. Let me tweak a couple numbers here. So A2, instead of being 180, is going to be 350. And we'll make this one 225 is now the highest. Here we go. So now you can see where I'm headed with this. Also, I wanted to do this. I'm going to use the formula text function in cell E2. So if someone's watching, they can quickly see what function I used in every one of these cells without having to rewind the video. So there are the functions that I used. Now, one more time, just so you know you could do this. If I wanted to, I could have just combined them all. I prefer the way I did this, showing the highest and lowest number. But I could have done the sum minus the max of A2 to A21 minus the minimum of A2 to A21 divided by, here you go, on this one, I would have divided by the count. The count function always counts numbers. It does not count text. I'm going to get the wrong answer here because I need to do some open and close parenth. Real quick, let me just fix this one more time. Do the count minus 2, edit that up there. And I want to do this part first, the sum. And here we go. 154.44. By the way, if you want to know if these are the exact same functions, I just did them slightly different. If you want to know if they're right, let's do a sort. I forgot to do this. Sort smallest to largest. I'm over in cell A2. highlight all the numbers except the top and the bottom. Down in your status bar at the bottom of the screen, it does read 154.44. So these are correct. Here we go. I did not know that the function that I'm about to show you even existed in Excel. It is called trim mean. So the key is this. I've got 20 numbers. You need to know how many numbers you have. And then you need to come up with a percentage. I want to eliminate two numbers. So 2 divided by 20 is 10%. So equals trim mean. And there's the Microsoft's official definition of it. It has two arguments. Both arguments are required. What array or range do you have? Comma, what percentage of the numbers do you want to exclude? I was real specific about this. I want to exclude 2 of the 20, so that's 10%. But the two numbers that I'm excluding, one will be the bottom and one will be the top. So I'm going to type in 0.1. I should get 154.44. And I do. Let me go ahead and do the formula text there for that one. And then let's just tweak this real quick before we're done. So now let's say I want to exclude 4 numbers. 4 divided by 20. That is going to be 20%, I believe. So if I do this as 0.2, that excluded the top 2 numbers and the bottom 2. Let's test it real quick. If you notice, I only selected A3 to A19, and down at the bottom it says 152.6875. It is working. And again, this would come in really handy when you start getting into numbers like this one right here that I'm doing now. 500. There you go. So I tweaked the numbers in column A. I got the number 1 and 3. I got the number 500 and 200,000 or something down there, and now everything's out of whack, except I'm looking pretty good right here with this. That's really accurate. I hope you enjoyed this video. Give me any comments or suggestions. Ring the bell. Have a wonderful day. I appreciate your time. Thank you.